Good morning, aspirants, and we are back, and we are back with this new series on Indian geography. And we will start this video with the most difficult, the most ignored part of Indian geography. Many of us don't know a lot about Northeast India, and it's quite important. Many questions are asked in various exams from this particular region only, and they are an integral part of India, but just because of lack of proper communication or transportation, we are yet to learn a lot of things about them. So let's try and get to know what the Northeast is all about. So the first slide that we have, it shows the Northeast. This is the northeastern part of our country. This is called as the Seven Sisters. Why Seven Sisters? Because these are seven states: Sikkim, Meghalaya, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram, and Tripura. Okay. Also, the capitals are mentioned. Gangtok is the capital of Sikkim. Itanagar is the capital of Arunachal. Kohima is the capital of Nagaland. Imphal is the capital of Manipur. Mizoram is the state. Aswal is its capital. Agartala is the capital of Tripura. Shillong is the capital of Meghalaya. Meghalaya, as you know, is also the state where the largest amount of rainfall occurs. Most rainfall occurs in Meghalaya all over the world. And the last is Assam. Assam's capital is Guwahati. Okay. So many times people will try to confuse you that no, it's Dispur. Dispur is the capital of Assam, but no, it's not so. The capital of Assam is Guwahati. Okay. Okay, guys, so our question here is the Yarlung Tsangpo. Yarlung Tsangpo bhi kehte hain, Yarlung Tsangpo bhi kehte hain, aur Yalu Tsangpo bhi kehte hain. Ye kis nadi ka dusra naam hai? Is the other name of which river? So as you can see, I have given a map for your consultation purpose, and you can see the Yarlung Tsangpo. This is the Tibet Autonomous Region of China. And it flows via this path, and then it comes down to India via this path. So basically, the Yarlung Tsangpo is the upper stream of river Brahmaputra. Meaning, ye Tibet mein jab behti hai, from where it originates, to there this river is known as the Yarlung Tsangpo or the Yarlung Tsangpo. When it makes its way into the Indian territory, it is called as the Brahmaputra. Okay. So some additional things that we should know about the Brahmaputra river is that it is a transboundary river, meaning ye jo river hai, this crosses the boundary of China. Obviously, China has claimed the Tibet Autonomous Region as its own. So it crosses that boundary, gets into India. So that is why it's called as the transboundary river. Also, it has its origin in the Mansarovar region. Okay, so Mansarovar lake ke paas se iska udyam hota hai, and it makes its way to the Bay of Bengal where it joins the sea. Okay, so the next question that we have is the only floating national park in the world. So the floating national park, first of all, we have to understand what is floating national park. How can a national park float? वो तो लैंड पर होता है, so how can it float? So the thing is, here in this national park, Kebul Lamjao, that is the answer, Kebul Lamjao National Park, it is situated in the Bishnupur district of Manipur, the state. And why it is floating? Because there you can find a lot of shrubbery, a lot of grass that is floating on the water of the lake. Okay. And floating on the water of the lake, it lies in the Loktak Lake region, and that floats, and it is known as Fumri. That floating grassland is called as Fumri. So that is why it is the only floating national park in the world. Recently, you might have heard the news that there is a school which has been established in this region, and also the state animal of Manipur, that is the Sangai. We will show you a picture later. And the Sangai, which is a subspecies of brow antlered deer. that is also indigenous to this area. And there is various kinds of legends and folk tales associated with the Sangay. So the answer here is Kebul Lamjao National Park in Manipur. So here we have Nunmati Oil Refinery is located in the state of Assam. Here I have shown you on the map also. It is quite near to Guwahati. And Assam is quite well known for oil excavation and extraction because also the country's oldest oil field is located in Digboi in Assam, somewhere around the Dibrugarh region. Okay. So moving on to the next question. The Indian National Army hoisted the Indian flag for the first time on the sacred soil of which place? So the correct answer here is in Manipur. I have shown you on the map. Manipur, there is a small town called Moirang. So Moirang is the place where the Indian National Army hoisted the Indian flag for the first time. Okay. Moving on. The oldest oil refinery in India is located at. So I have already mentioned this in the previous question. It is located at Digboi in Assam, the oldest oil refinery. And the place is situated near Tinsukia. Here you can see Dibrugarh, here is Tinsukia. So that is quite clear. Now, India's highest annual rainfall is located at. So I told you that highest rainfall is located in the state of Meghalaya in India, whose capital is Shillong. And all over the world, nowhere it rains more than at this place. So the correct answer is Mausonram in Meghalaya. You can see on the map also. It's very important to remember the locations because you may be given a map and asked to denote it on the map. So moving on. The Kaziranga National Park is located in which place? So the Kaziranga National Park, I have already shown you on the map. It is located in the state of Assam. One horned rhinoceros, ek seeing wala ganda. That is the main attraction, main animal which is found here in this place. And it is a protected marshland teeming with nature. The marshland you will learn later when I will tell you about the Ramsar Convention and all that. So this is the Kaziranga National Park. Now, which state is called as the land of sunrise? So guys, if you look at the geography of the Indian mainland and the extent of the Indian mainland, तो जो लैटिट्यूड और लॉन्गिट्यूड्स होते हैं ना, तो लैटिट्यूड्स के मामले में दिस इज सिचुएटेड, लॉन्गिट्यूड्स के मामले में, आई एम सॉरी, दिस इज सिचुएटेड द इंडियन मेनलैंड, उसकी बाउंड्री जो है वो 68 डिग्री 7 मिनट्स ईस्ट से लेकर 97 डिग्री 25 मिनट्स ईस्ट तक एक्सटेंड होती है. तो दिस पॉइंट विच यू सी ना, द ईस्टर्न मोस्ट पॉइंट, दैट इज 97 डिग्री 25 मिनट्स ईस्ट. सो that is where the boundary of India ends. And obviously, since the sunrise hits the eastern part of the country earliest, so that is why the sunrise occurs earliest in the state of Arunachal Pradesh. Hence, it is called as the land of sunrise. Good to know fact that recently the government has launched a branch of DD Doordarshan channel, DD Arun Prabha, for this state specifically. Moving on. Shillong is also known as. So Shillong is the capital of Meghalaya. Very nice place, very scenic place. And it is also known as the capital of Meghalaya, and it is also known as the Scotland of India. Okay. Okay. Now we have come to the section on the state animals of all the states in the Northeast. So the first and foremost is Meghalaya. And the state animal of Meghalaya is the clouded leopard. Here you can see it's such a magnificent animal. And to help you remember, we are including the pictures also. Okay, so here we have come to the very interesting question, the state animal of the state of Manipur. So this here you can see it's a form of deer. Actually, it's a subspecies of the bro-antlered deer. And it is found specifically in the Kebul Lamjao National Park. It's the only floating national park in the world, and it's called the Sangay. The Sangay is the state animal of Manipur. Okay. Now the state animal of Mizoram. तो द स्टेट एनिमल ऑफ मिजोरम, इट्स अ गोट लाइक एनिमल ऑफ द जीनस कैप्रिकॉर्निस, एज यू कैन सी मेंशनड हियर, एंड यू कैन सी इट लुक्स लाइक अ गोट बट स्लाइटली थिनर, स्लाइटली टॉलर, एंड इट्स कॉल्ड द सेराओ. स्पेसिफिकली इट इज कॉल्ड द सुमात्रन सेराओ. ओके, सेराओ इट्स अ काइंड ऑफ गोट बट टॉलर, एंड ऑल्सो सिंस इट्स हिली एरिया इट हैज मोर इंड्योरेंस फॉर दैट काइंड ऑफ टेरेन. ओके, स्टेट एनिमल ऑफ असम, सो ऑब्वियसली फाउंड इन द काजीरंगा नेशनल पार्क, इट्स द वन हॉर्न राइनोसरस. गुड टू नो फैक्ट, द राइनो हॉर्न इज मेड अप ऑफ प्राइमरली ऑफ अ सब्सटेंस कॉल्ड केराटिन. इट्स अ फॉर्म ऑफ प्रोटीन विच इज फाउंड इन हेयर, फिंगर नेल्स, एनिमल हूफ्स. तो जिस सब्सटेंस के आपके बाल, आपके नाखून बने होते हैं ना, दैट इज द एग्जैक्ट सेम थिंग ऑफ विच इट्स हॉर्न इज यू नो मेड ऑफ, एंड इट्स पोच्ड एंड यू नो हंटेड इलीगली बिकॉज ऑफ दैट. इट्स वेरी वैल्यूएबल इन द चाइनीज मेडिसिन मार्केट एंड अदर काइंड्स ऑफ मेडिकल यूजेस, सो कॉल्ड मेडिकल यूजेस. नथिंग्स यू नो कंक्लूसिव अबाउट दैट. सो मूविंग ऑन, द स्टेट एनिमल ऑफ नागालैंड. नागालैंड इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग प्लेस गाइज, क्विजीन वाइज ऑल्सो वेरी नाइस फूड. सो द स्टेट एनिमल इज गायाल और मिथुन. इट्स अ फॉर्म ऑफ बोवाइन एनिमल, मीनिंग यू नो कैटल विच कैन बी डोमेस्टिकेटेड, एंड यू कैन सी द पिक्चर हेयर. सो इट्स स्लाइटली बिगर देन द काउज और बफेलोज दैट वी आर यूज टू, एंड पीपल से दैट इट इज यू नो डिराइव्ड और इट्स डिलिनिएटेड विद द एंसेस्ट्री ऑफ गौर, दैट वाइल्ड बफेलो दैट वी हैव इन द फॉरेस्ट ऑफ नॉर्थ ईस्ट एंड हिमालयन रीजन, गौर. तो दैट गौर इज सेट टू बी द फोर फादर और एंसेस्टर ऑफ दिस गायाल और मिथुन. द स्टेट एनिमल ऑफ त्रिपुरा, ऑब्वियसली इट्स अ फॉर्म ऑफ प्राइमेट, एन एप. सो दिस इज द फेयर्स लंगूर. द फेयर्स लंगूर इज द स्टेट एनिमल ऑफ त्रिपुरा. कैपिटल ऑफ त्रिपुरा इज अगरतला. द स्टेट एनिमल ऑफ सिक्किम, इट्स अ वेरी क्यूट लिटिल आर्बोरियल एनिमल, द रेड पांडा. इट फीड्स मेनली ऑन बैम्बू. इट्स क्वाइट वल्नरेबल. यू कैन चेक द कंजर्वेशन स्टेटस ऑन द इंटरनेट. विकीपीडिया विल मेंशन इट एज इंडेंजर्ड, एंड इट फीड्स मेनली ऑन बैम्बू. इट्स वेरी शाय, ट्राइज टू हाइड इन द ट्रीज. बीहू इज द डांस ऑफ विच स्टेट? सो वी हैव कम टू द लोकल फोक कल्चर, एंड बीहू एज यू कैन सी वेरी ब्यूटिफुल डांस. इट्स अ डांस ऑफ असम. लोकली इट इज नोन एज बोंगाई बीहू. मूविंग ऑन, द हाइएस्ट पीक इन मिजोराम. हाइएस्ट पीक इन मिजोराम इज द ब्लू माउंटेन. यू कैन सी द पिक्चर हेयर, एंड लोकली इट इज नोन एज फोंग पुई. फोंग पुई इज द ऑल्सो नोन एज द ब्लू माउंटेन, इज द हाइएस्ट पीक इन मिजोरम. एलिवेशन इज 2157 मीटर. कंपेयर्ड विद द माउंट एवरेस्ट, माउंट एवरेस्ट इज 8848 मीटर्स. सो दैट शुड गिव यू एन आइडिया. इट्स अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 1/4 द हाइट ऑफ माउंट एवरेस्ट. मूविंग ऑन, चेरो इज द डांस ऑफ, चेरो इज द डांस ऑफ मिजोरम. चेरो वेरी ब्यूटिफुल हेड ड्रेसेस, वाइट रेड एंड ग्रीन ड्रेसेस. बारदो छाम इज द डांस ऑफ, सो बारदो छाम इज द डांस ऑफ अरुणाचल प्रदेश. यू कैन सी पीपल आर वेयरिंग मास्क एंड दे हैव कलरफुल ड्रेसेस ऑन. बागुरुम्बा इज द डांस ऑफ, सो बागुरुम्बा इज अ लोकल फोक डांस ऑफ असम. असम यू कैन सी ऑल द लेडीज परफॉर्मिंग द डांस. चांगलो इज द डांस ऑफ, सो बेसिकली चांगलो इज द डांस ऑफ नागालैंड, एंड इट बेसिकली बिलोंग्स टू द चांग ट्राइब ऑफ नागालैंड, एंड एज यू कैन सी इट्स क्वाइट अ एग्रेसिव मार्शल काइंड ऑफ डांस. पीपल आर ड्रेस्ड एज वॉरियर्स, सो दैट इज वन थिंग यू शुड कीप इन माइंड. सिंगी छाम, सिंगी छाम और द स्नो लायन डांस इज द डांस ऑफ विच स्टेट? सो सिंगी छाम द स्नो लायन डांस. यू कैन सी द स्नो लायन, सो कॉल्ड मास्क, सो कॉल्ड गियर दैट दे आर वियरिंग. इट लुक्स लाइक अ लायन एंड इट इज द डांस ऑफ सिक्किम. कीप दैट इन माइंड. होजागिरी इज द डांस ऑफ, सो होजागिरी इज द डांस ऑफ त्रिपुरा अगेन. सो नाउ फेस्टिवल्स. द हॉर्नबिल फेस्टिवल बिलोंग्स टू द स्टेट. हॉर्नबिल फेस्टिवल इज वेरी फेमस, वेरी वेरी फेमस इन द नॉर्थ ईस्ट. typically celebrated in the months of October to December, and it's showcases the culture of Nagaland, showcases the cuisine of Nagaland, the food, the dance, the traditions. And so Hornbill Festival is the dance, is the festival of Nagaland. The Losar Festival. So Losar is predominantly a Buddhist festival, belongs to the state of Arunachal Pradesh. You can see various Buddhist monks in the picture provided here. And it is a festival in Tibetan Buddhism. The holiday is celebrated on various dates, and you can see there is information about it being the first day of the lunisolar Tibetan calendar. Now, the Sagadawa Festival. The Sagadawa is also a kind of Buddhist festival, also celebrated in the state of Sikkim. You can see they have made banners depicting the Buddha. And last, the Cherry Blossom Festival belongs to which state? The Cherry Blossom Festival is very interesting, because the most interesting thing which happens is that the cherry trees, they blossom and they look very beautiful, like here shown in the picture. And that natural phenomena has been taken by the state of Meghalaya to showcase other aspects of the state's culture, folk dance, cuisine, traditions, organizes a tourism circuit, everything is there. So this was the first part on our series on the Northeast, and I hope you found it informative and you had a lot of information from this absorbed as your own. Do like this video, share this with your friends, subscribe to the channel, tell us what else you want us to make videos on, and do tell your friends about these videos, do share it with them. These are very, very helpful, and more such videos will come in the future. Thank you guys. Keep preparing, keep working hard. Good luck to you all.